and welcome back to the Prodea Academy YouTube channel. I'm Michelle, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about Financial Forecasting 101. So if you own a business or you're looking to start up a new venture, then improving its performance would definitely have crossed your mind. So this is where financial forecasting comes into play. And in today's video, we are going to touch on what financial forecasting is, why it's important, and the two types available. So with that said, let's jump straight in. What is financial forecasting? Well, quite simply put, it is the process of looking into the future of your business based on historical data and trends. In more specific terms, it is the processing, predicting, and estimating the future performance of your business based on the available data that you have. So using the information available to you and making projections about the future performance of your business. Okay, so we know what financial forecasting is, but the next question is, why is it important? Well, it is important because any business with long-term objectives would benefit from this process. You are essentially using forecasting to help set new standards for your business, and forecasting will guide you in your decision-making process. Another reason why forecasting is important is to convince investors. So let's use the example of you owning a winery and you wish to expand your operations into various states. You know that it's going to be successful, but how do you attract more investors? So how do you convince others that the business is going to be successful? This is where financial forecasting is imperative, because you'd be able to accurately determine the future of your winery by considering all the variables in your current model and projecting them into a future scenario. So CEOs love this model because it can bring very important insights, such as how business resources will be spent, what the industry holds for the future, how long debts will hover over the business, and how to pay the shareholders. So all of this kind of information comes to light when you undergo the financial forecasting process. So at least if you have an idea of what you're diving into, you can make the right decisions at the right time, which becomes a lot less of a burden on your shoulders. This then brings us to the two major branches of forecasts, that being qualitative and quantitative. Qualitative financial forecasting doesn't rely on computers to analyze large data sets. Instead, it's quite an unorthodox way of finding out the connection between events. Rather than following the sales figures, qualitative financial forecasting focuses on decisions taken from experience and intuition. It starts with the gathering of opinions from major positions in each department, and these are then analyzed for their insights, again relying on experience. And some methods to qualitative forecasting include the Delphi method and scenario forecasting. Quantitative forecasting, on the other hand, solely depends on large historical data sets, and these are used to find patterns and trends in the business space. Now, these forecasts are more accurate in sectors where numbers speak louder than legacy, and some methods available in the quantitative forecasting space include pro forma financial statements, time series analysis, and cause and effect. That brings us to the close of today's video. But as always, we thank you for joining us. And should you have any thoughts, comments, or suggestions for future content that you'd be interested in, please feel free to pop that in the comment section below. Please also join us on our social media platforms. You can find us on LinkedIn and Facebook, or at our website at prodeafinancial.com. Prodea Academy, striving to achieve better accounting for everyone.